This is Team 60, so this is the 60th year that they've had football at Eastglen. It's been tough. We weren't getting the kids out, not enough support financially, and we really struggled. Just to the point where we were almost looking at folding the team.
I'll go into grade 12. This will be my second year. I'm hoping that when the school year starts, a lot of people will come out, more people will come out, and we'll have more to fill the team. That way, it can give some of our players a break.
When I came for the open house, I signed up for the football camp in June. I'm here to get myself better, because I know when I first started here, I wasn't that good, and I'm already can see myself improving. My cardio's gotten better, my strength has gotten better, and I'm here to have fun.
I was homeschooled since kindergarten. I lived on a lot of bases, a lot of small towns my entire life because my dad's in the military.
It's a way to knock the ball down, Lucas. Nice job, Lucas.
And so to be in a public school now, I'm finally somewhere solid. I think Coach is worried about everything. You can tell by his hairline, the guy doesn't have any more hair, but he can be tough. But I mean, I think all the best coaches are. He's tough when he needs to be, and he's a father when he has to be, and he's just a good guy. He's a real good guy.
This is a different bubble. Okay? So Lyle, you're gonna go on the cone, you're gonna get ready to go down the field, and then you back up, and then you go. Okay?
He's a great coach. He's like a father. I never had a dad growing up. So when I met him,
he's come a long way, Josh. Long way. He's matured a lot, and he's become a very good player. We joke around, we get along really well, and his mom, as I say, is very supportive of me and the program.
That was a very positive thing to watch. James Logan is, I think, vastly improved, even since we played him.
Some things that stood out. Anybody notice anything or anything? What's that, Josh?
They're gods.
They're gods. Okay, you know why they're gods? They put in the time and the effort. But the coach, they never talk about winning. They just talk about perfect effort. Mm-hmm. If you can put perfect effort in, that's all we ask from you guys. Okay, but it is a grind, and you can see the passion. Anything else you noticed? How'd they feel about each other?
Like family.
Family. It's nothing but hard work, guys. It's just nothing but hard work. But the things you get out of it at the end, the friendships, okay, will last you a long, long time. Came back to our home this afternoon, invited the guys over to meet my family and see where I live and that kind of thing, and see I'm a real person. I have a real life, so not just live in the school and that.
Ready? Focus!
Okay, guys, thank you. I just wanted to do one thing. It's kind of corny, but you know that these are fairly easy to break, right? But if I get a whole bunch of them and I stack them together, you can't break them. They're real strong, and that's kind of what we need from all of you guys. I've got a whole box of these. I want you to write down what you're gonna commit to this team.
On behalf of Nissan Canada, our employees, our great dealer partners, I'd want to reveal the latest addition to the Eastglen football department. This new locker room. What do you think?
We gotta go out and warm up. I don't think we're gonna have time to come back. I just want to wish you luck. I want you to do a good job and play as hard as you can. Okay, remember we said, if you make a mistake, make it go 100 miles an hour and hit them. Play to the whistle. Okay. When you walk out the door, tap our flag and make sure you play like a champion. Let's go.
I managed to break my finger and get a injury in my hand, so it's stopping us from having me play right now. I'm hoping maybe to be back for the second game. It's just a minor injury, and yeah, it's better for the long run. I mean, I'd rather miss one game versus a whole season.
That kid's fast.
Right off the bat.
Good tackle. Good tackle.
Nice tackle.
Travis Young convert is good.
Fight! Hey!
There's no infraction on the plate.
You can't be 3 yards back. Your one job is go forward every time. You can't do that. That happens.
Anderson, we need another player for Josh. We're on 11 guys here right now.
Run a post!
Is it your knee in just here?
Okay.
First year playing 12-man football, I'm definitely concerned. Obviously, you know, you have your good days, your bad days.
Lucas is a great leader. Even though he's younger than me, that's who I see as a leader.
That's it, boys! Perfect effort! It's what we need!
Since I'm grade 12, I gotta make every moment count. This, to me, is the last, it's the end of the line, basically, so.
There were some girls sitting behind me from Eastglen, and I turned around and I said, because I had lost my voice, I said, okay, you guys have to cheer really loud because I can't.
The friends that he's got now compared to what he had before, I find that these guys, they all watch out for each other. You know, when he goes out to hang out with them, I'm not as worried because I know that they got each other's backs. And they're all a good group of kids. I'm very proud of the Eastglen boys. I hope that they, you know, it would be nice if they made it all the way to provincials. It would be huge. Huge boost in their morale. But even if they don't, I just think, you know, enjoying this last year with all these guys, I think it's going to be good for him because who knows what's going to happen after graduation.
Yeah, right.
How fast can you guys run 25 yards? Really quick, right?
Yeah.
So what should be the main focus when you guys punt the ball?
Getting down.
Block. Because if you get off quick, you're just gonna run in the 5-yard pocket, it's gonna be a 15-yard penalty every time. Coaches said you have all these problems, okay? So what I wanna see here when he snaps it, I wanna see a 2-full Mississippi block. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, plant, then go, okay? And what you guys are gonna find, when the ball actually comes down, you're gonna be, you know, 6-7 yards away. I'll give you the Mississippi, okay? Do your regular cadence.
Set.
1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, go. That's the process. See, you don't even need to back up though, right?
That was awesome, yeah. I mean, we've had trouble with no yards where the ball's kicked and then we're within 5 yards. And Ryan right there just explained it perfectly. That's just huge.
Most of his peers went to a different high school. He chose Eastglen. Not very many kids from his junior high went there because he wanted a new start. And football was part of that. He didn't necessarily excel in junior high socially. I think junior high is a really tough time, and frankly, kids are mean. And Will's an easy target because of his size.
I was working in the garage, and he came in, and he started crying. It's hard to see your kids come home from school every day and cry.
We were really concerned, and this, he comes home, he's happy, he's just, he is a completely different kid. And football has been a very, very major factor in the difference in our boy today.
Truthfully, Coach Anderson is the heart and soul of the team.
He does put in an exorbitant amount of time. You know, his whole summer vacation is spent at the school every night.
Some people don't realize he doesn't get paid to do that. He doesn't have to be there. He's there because he wants us to succeed on the field and in the classroom.
And again, if you can put it in your journal, that would be awesome. No right or wrong, I just want you to be imaginative. But use the facts that we've talked about, okay?
All right. You know, last year wasn't the best. I wasn't a part of the team. But now it's just people like, hey, you're on the football team. Like, it's been huge for me. The respect I've gotten from other kids in the school, and I've gotten more respect for myself just because, you know, I'm not like that kid I was last year where I didn't really have much respect for myself, didn't really care to this year.
By the end of grade 9, he was pretty damaged. It was, you know, it was a fight to get him to go to school. Like, he didn't even want to go to his grade 9 grad. For him to suck all that up and walk into a place that he doesn't know anybody, he's had negative experiences with peers his own age. You know, he really was opening himself up again to, you know, something that potentially would, you know, cause him more hurt.
Our kicker, Brendan, he said to me, he's like, man, I wish I would have known you when you were getting bullied, because you would have never gotten bullied if I was with you. Because he said, I would have had your back.
Yeah.
It's good to be nervous, right? Okay, it's a big game. So that's understandable. I want to talk about Will for a minute. Hopefully I don't embarrass him. And he's confided in me, and I hope this is okay to bring out, but he mentioned it's maybe some guys that had it in for him in junior high playing on this team tonight. Okay? We better have his back tonight. They do anything to him, we better have his back. They say anything to him, they touch him, they stomp on him on the ground. I don't care. Everybody's got your back tonight. You understand? You're starting tonight, and you're going to do a hell of a job.
That's right.
Go, Will. They say anything. Get him. Okay. Let's go eat.
Halfway down the field.
Once you're done, sit quietly and get ready. Start getting focused.
Touchdown!
Okay, first of all, I commend you on your discipline. And you're gonna get more of it in the second half. Just walk away, play your game, knock their asses off, help them up, smile. But knock them down. Legal, okay?
It's okay, it's all good. We still got it. We're good.
I'm definitely impressed how far Will has come. I think Will put it behind him. I think every time he goes on the field, he puts all those negative things behind him, and he excels, and he has excelled, and I'm extremely proud to be his captain, be on the same team as him. After school, I go home. That's what I did in junior high, for obvious reasons. But now, like, I'm just gonna stay around a little bit more. I'm gonna socialize with some people, and I'm gonna try to join a few other sports teams, like the handball team, the basketball team, just stuff like that, because, I don't know. Being in a sports team makes high school so much better. Just makes everything more enjoyable. The team never stops hanging out. You know, we're like brothers, we're like family. We'll be together every day, whether football is after school or during school or not till the very next year. The football guys, we stick together. I've made lots of friendships. I've bettered myself in a lot of ways, and you know, it's been a really good season. It's been more than just football. It's been way more than that. We honestly are a family now. Like, it's everybody likes each other. Everybody gets along.
I don't know where I would be without football right now. You know, my life would be totally different. It's completely changed my life. So, you know, it's sad that this is my last season, right? Because I have built such a strong bond with Coach that I am gonna miss him, like, a lot, right? But, you know, that's just the way it goes, I guess. Can't stay in high school forever. You gotta move on. But I am gonna miss him a lot. He's a great coach.
Yeah. Okay, we'll see you after school. Okay. All right, go to class.
Yeah. Well, I have
This has been a long year. We started training in February, March, and spring camp, and then summer camp, and they keep me going. Their passion keeps me going. Their energy keeps me going. If I'm down or I'm tired at the end of a day, that I get in there and, you know, they're back ready to go, and they've pumped me up, and I give them a lot of credit. This is the most of them never played sport before, played football before, and their courage and their passion has really inspired me to work as hard as I can for them.
Hello, Eastglen Blue Devils. My name is Steve Ryan, Director of Marketing at Nissan Canada. I wanted to personally congratulate all of you on a hard-fought season. The Blue Devils made the Nissan Back in the Game program a complete success. Win or lose, you exemplified perfect effort in every game and made us all very proud. Before every game, you tap a flag that says, play like a champion today. So Nissan thought, you should see a championship game. This season, the Eastglen Blue Devils are going to the Grey Cup in Vancouver. Nissan and the CFL have arranged a private jet to fly to Vancouver to see the 102nd Grey Cup live. Before the game, you'll go on a behind-the-scenes tour of BC Place, and you'll watch a closed practice of one of the teams. From all of us at Nissan Canada, and from all of our participating Nissan dealers, enjoy your trip.